Good morning, student. In our last class, we discussed about the ascending order and descending order, and greater than and less than. Now, our next topic is write the place value of the color digit. Okay, write the place value of the color digit. First question: 2956. In 2956, we have to find out the place value of digit 9. Okay, we have to find out the place value of digit 9. In this question, 2956, 6 represents the value of 1s and 5 represents the value of 10. 9 represents the value of 100 and 2 represents the value of 1000. Okay, in this question, digit 6 represents the value of 1s, 5 represents the value of 10s, and digit 9 represents the value of 100, and digit 2 represents the value of 1000. Okay? The place value of 9, that means 9 represents the value of 100. That is 9 into 100 equal to 900. Okay? This is the place value of digit 9 in 2956. Okay? In this question, 3549, digit 9 represents the value of 1. Digit 4 represents the value of 10, and digit 5 represents the value of 100, and digit 3 represents the value of 1000. Okay? In this question, the value of digit 4 represents the value of 10. Okay? That's why the place value of 4 is 4 into 10 equal to 40. Okay? 40 is the place value of the 4, digit 4 in 3549. Okay? In next question, 9243, we have to find out the digit 9 place value. Okay? In this question, 3 represents the value of 1. 4 represent the value of 10, okay, and 2 represent the value of 100, okay, and 9 represent the value of 1000. So the place value of 9 is 9000. That means 9 into 1000, it become 9000. Okay, this is the place value of digit 9 in 9243. Okay? In next question, 8649, we have to find out the digit 6 place value. Okay? In this question, 9 represents the place value of 1 and 4 represent the place value of 10. 6 represents the place value of 100 and 8 represents the place value of 1000. Okay? The place value of 6 is 600. Okay? That means it becomes 6 into 100 equal to 600. The place value of digit 6 is 600 in the given question. Okay? Our next topic is fill in the boxes. Okay? The first question in given series 667 and 669 and 671 represent the increasing order of series. This is the series of increasing order, in form of increasing order. Okay? Where 667 and 669 always represent 667 and is 71 is always greater than 669. So this is the increasing order of series. Where when we add 2 in our first number, we get to the next number. When we add 2 in this number, we get to our next number. Okay. When we add 2 in 667, we get 669. And when we add 2 in 669, we get 671. Like that, when we add 2 in 671, we get our next number. So our next number is 673. Okay? When we add 2 in 673, we get our next number. So our next number is 675. When we add 2 in 675, we get our next number. Our next number is 677. Okay? So when we add 2 in 677, we get our next number. The next number is 679. So what we observe in this series? This series is increasing order of numbers. Where when we add 2 in our previous number, we get to our next number. Okay? In second question, our next question is, in this series, 2350 and x number is 3350. And our next number is 4350. What we have done? This is the increasing order of series. This is the increasing order of series where 3350 is always greater than 2350. And 4350 is always greater than 3350. Okay? When we add 1000, when we add 1000 in our first number 2350, we get our next number 3350. Again, when we add 1000 in 3350, we get our next number 4350. Okay, like that, when we add 1000 in 4350, we get our next number. So our next number is 5350. Again, when we add 1000 in 5350, we get our next number 6350. Okay? When we add 1000 in 6350, we get our next number. Next number is 7350. Again, when we add 1000 in this number, we get our next number. When we add 1000 in 7350, we get our next number 8350. Okay? So, what can we say? This is increasing order of series where when we add 1000 in our previous number, we get our next number. In our next question, 3700 and 3800 and 3900. In this series, what we observe, 3800 is always greater than 3700. And 3900 is always greater than 3800. Okay? Why? Because in 100 place there is 7, and here in 100 place there is 8, and in this number 100 place there is 9. Okay. So 9 is always greater than 8 and 8 is always greater than 7. That's why we can say that this is increasing order of series. This is an increasing order of series where when we add 100 in our previous number, we get our next number. So when we add 100 in 3700, we get next number 3800. When we add 100 in 3800, 900. Like that, when we add 100 in 3900, we get our next number. So our next number is 4000. Okay? When we add 100 in 4000, we get our next number. So our next number is 4100. When we add 100 again in this number, we get our next number. When we add 100 in 4100, we get next number 4200. When we add 100 in 4200, we get our next number. Our next number is 4300. So what can we say? When we add 100 to our previous number, we get our next number in the given series. That's why this series is increasing order of series. Next question. In our next question, 3540 and in 3550, 3550 is always greater than 3540. Why? Here, in 10 place, there is 5 and in here 4. So 5 is always greater than 4. That's why this number is always greater than this number. Okay? So when we add 10 in 3540, we get our next number 3550. When we add 10 in 3550, we get our next number 3560. Like that, when we add 10 in 3560, we get our next number. Our next number is 3570. Okay? When we add 10 in 3570, we get our next number. So our next number is 3580. When we add 10 in 3580, we get our next number. Our next number is 3590. Again, when we add 10 in 3590, we get our next number, and our next number is 3600. Okay? So what we observe in this series, when we add 10 in previous number, we get our next number. Okay? Our next question is, write the successor of the greatest 4-digit number and the predecessor of the smallest 4-digit number. Okay? Our question divided into two parts, where our first part says that, write the successor of the greatest 4-digit number. In our previous classes, we know about the greatest number. So, greatest 4-digit number, that means the numbers have 4 digits, which are 1, 10, 100 and 1000. And we know that the greatest 4 digit number is 9999 in our previous classes. Okay? So now we have to know that, we have to know about what is successor. What is successor? Okay? Successor means when we add one in given number, okay? When we add one in any given number, so we get another number, and this number is called successor of the previous number. Here, our previous number is the greatest 4-digit number, 9999. When we add 1 in 9999, we get okay? What we have got? When we add 1 in our previous number or in our given number, we get another number, and the number is known as successor of the given number. Okay. In our second part, says that the predecessor of the smallest 4-digit number. We know that what is the smallest 4-digit number? 4-digit number here. The numbers have 4 digits, that means 1, 10, 100, and 1000. And smallest 4-digit number is 1000. So, what we have to find? One, we have to know about what is predecessor. Okay? In predecessor, we subtract 1 from given number. When we subtract one in our given number, we get another number, and this number is known as the predecessor of the given number. Okay. When we subtract 1 from 1000, we get 999. That means 999. 999 is known as the predecessor of 1000. Okay.